Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. I explained in the previous update about the convergence of planetary and lunar geometry, in particular the lunar conjunction with Saturn and also planetary geometry involving Mercury. And as you can see, we had quite a cluster of stronger earthquakes, indeed, I estimated around the second, and on the first actually, peaking magnitude 6.6. An obvious seismic response to that convergence of planetary geometry. You may want to look up the previous update for a detailed analysis of that geometry. We also see here, if we look back at the 25th, there was a very tight convergence. You may remember that one. And we also had an obvious seismic response that was minimal clustering, but we did have a 6.3 there. And now on the first, we had a 6.6. And as you can see, we have stronger earthquakes across the planet. This is temporal clustering. And this is a phenomenon in seismology that is still not well explained. But as you can see here on the SGI graph, planetary and lunar geometry perfectly explains why this happens. Okay, so this is what we actually had. And you may also remember that I had question marks about the fourth and the fifth with the lunar conjunctions with Venus and with Uranus. So on the next SGI graph, you see again the planetary and lunar geometry as discussed in the previous update. And I emphasized the planetary conjunctions with Mercury, Mars, Uranus, that was on the second, and Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and that is on the third, was yesterday. And this combination could result in a major seismic event. And my estimate would be that it could be following the lunar geometry. There's the semi-right angle lunar geometry that we have on the 4th and 5th, involving Saturn, Jupiter, and Neptune. If we look at the solar system, we see the planetary conjunctions, Mercury, Mars, and Uranus, and also Venus, Mars, and Jupiter. And there is some 1.5 days in between, so it may not be too strong. I'm not at all sure about that, but there could be an obvious seismic response to those two planetary conjunctions following the lunar geometry that we have on today and tomorrow. This is, like I said, semi-right angle lunar geometry with Jupiter, Neptune, and Saturn. And Jupiter is practically in between, in that it is actually on the 4th, later on the 4th, later today, and the lunar geometry of Saturn precedes that, and the lunar geometry of Neptune follows that geometry of Jupiter. Jupiter is in between here, as you can see. And again, back at the SGI graph, we could have an obvious seismic response to that geometry following that lunar geometry that could already be later today, I would say around the 5th, give or take one day. There is the potential for a major seismic event. If you look at atmospheric fluctuations that we had in the last couple of days, I only emphasize those fluctuations that could impact human life. So remote areas in the ocean are less interesting at this point. I would emphasize Vanuatu, Loyalty Islands, Vanuatu region. There was a fluctuation there on the second, also marking North Japan, the Kuril Islands, potentially, and north of New Zealand, the Cameric Islands. And we also had the antipode that would mark, among other regions, Iran, South Central Iran, possibly. And I would particularly emphasize South and Central America. That could be a major event, major seismic event coming up. That was yesterday, fluctuations, a strong fluctuation, marking Chile, possibly Peru, Ecuador, but especially also Central America. That is definitely a candidate in my opinion. And its antipode would mark northeastern China. There can be major seismic events. It may take hundreds of years or decades for that to happen, but northeastern China can have major earthquakes, devastating earthquakes. And also northern part of Sumatra, that could have a stronger seismic event as well. These are the atmospheric fluctuations that we picked up in the last couple of days that could have an impact on human life. Check out the website for the latest updates, in particular the atmospheric fluctuations, and also our social media channels. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.